Tonight we present the Foot Locker three-point contest. The pressure is on. The drama is fierce. And the pace is fast. Hold on tight, everybody.
For a lot of folks, this is actually their favorite All-Star event. There's a lot of drama. It always seems to come down to the wire. And let's get it on.
Well, it's an event that I really enjoy, guys. Anytime you get the best shooters in the NBA together to duke it out, it's going to be a good time. And these guys on this roster tonight can all really struggle.
He has 60 seconds to make as many shots from behind the arc as he can. Clark, as you know, there's a money ball in each of the five racks worth double. That's 25 shots to get a maximum of 30.
And the corner threes are only 22 feet, but the other three-point stations are 23 feet 9 inches. So those are the longest shots.
And to me, the corner shot is the easiest of any of them. So it's important to get off to a quick start here. From that corner spot, maybe get 5 or 6 quick points.
To go. He's got 12. And for 13. Drains the money ball. He's got 16. Make it 17.
Rock solid shooting down the stretch.
18 points for him when all is said and done. His stroke looked terrific in that round, guys.
I think things are so much easier when a shooter gets off to a good start, and he certainly did that. Something the shooters have to avoid here is over-adjusting if the shots aren't falling.
Yeah, I agree, Clark. You can't over-adjust. And it has to be a very minor tweak. But sometimes, a shooter just has one thought that can get him into a good group. A little bit like a golfer. He just wants one swing thought, one shot thought. And if you can get to that point during this contest, you'll be in good shape.
At 7, he's got 8. Can't get the money ball. He's got 9. Got 10. 11 on the board. Can't get the money back. He's got 12. That's 13. Now 14. Makes it 4 straight for him. One rack left.
Yeah, this is how you do it.
And with that shot, he moves into sole possession of first place. He's on top. A very strong 20 points for him. He was really enjoying himself out there that time, guys.
Well, he really had it going at the end. And that's what you call going out on a high note. That was great stuff.
The hardest thing for a shooter might be just maintaining that same level of concentration through all five racks.
Yeah, I think it is the hardest thing, Clark, because you're just not used to taking 25 shots in 1 minute. And nobody does that. Even in practice, you don't really do it that way. So it's a very foreign feeling when you're out there, and you've got to maintain that focus.
All right.
Well, he's off to a decent start, guys. That's it.
10 points on the board. He racks down, 2 to go. Just 13. Is it 14? That makes it 4 straight for him. 3 of 4 on money balls. Now up to 18.
And he's alone in second place with that one.
He hits the 20 mark on the nose. Now that's how you do it. Outstanding focus throughout the round.
Yeah, he was really flowing at that point after he went 5 for 5 on that second rack. You know, it means so much to get off to a fast start in this competition. More often than not, as the first few racks go, so go the rest.
Yeah, it's a weird competition, Clark. Guys are not used to doing this during the season, taking so many shots in such a little time. So the quick start is imperative for your confidence and for your rhythm.
Now it's 6.
A pretty good start there for him.
He's up to 7. Now 8 points. Now 9 points. He needs 8 points more. And he buries his 5th in a row.
Take that. He's finding that touch now.
He needs 3 more points.
He's got 16.
Boy, he's really going for it in these last racks.
He's in 3rd. He's tied for 2nd. Good for 2nd. Finishes his last rack with plenty of time to spare. He comes away with a score of 21 on the round. Guys, hard to find any fault with that display.
Yeah, he had a good time out there. He hit a few in a row, and then he was off and running. I mean, he ended up burying 11 straight. In the history of this event, I think one moment that anyone who saw it remembers was Craig Hodges hitting his first 19 shots in the semifinal round back in 1991.
Yeah, that was unbelievable. Probably the greatest display of shooting that I've ever seen. I'll tell you what, Hodges did a lot of amazing things in point guard, but he won it three times during the 90s.
He needs 8 points more to stay in contention.
Now, 14. Honeyball, no good.
6 more points to stick around.
Now, the 15. He's got 16.
Ooh, starting to get a rhythm here.
Him up for 30.
And that puts him in a second place tie now.
That's tied him in the top spot in this round, guys.
24 points for him. He'll take that. Wow. How about that performance, guys? Man, this worked.
Yeah, an ideal start for him, nailing every ball off that first rack, and that really took a lot of pressure off him for the rest of the round.
He knows exactly what score will get him into the next round.
This is it, Steve, bringing up the rear.
Yeah, you know, everyone's already put forward with their best effort already, so he knows the number to beat. He knows what he's up against, and now it's just a matter of getting into his groove.
Six. That's seven. He's got eight. Can't get the money ball. He's got nine. Ten now. 11 points.
He needs 8 more points to advance.
14.
7 more points and he'll move on.
Up to 15 now. Good rack right there. 4 points total. That gives him 18.
One more to advance.
Now he's tied for third.
A 23-point round for him. Wow, that was something else, guys. We don't see too many performances like that.
Well, we all know how important the money balls are in this event, and he hit 4 out of 5 of them. That's very good work.
Wilts has got the highest score from round one. All he's got to do now, guys, is repeat that performance in the finals.
And just amazing scores up to this point. I mean, these guys have pushed each other to new heights this year. I love it.
Well, this is what you hope for coming into the shootout. Great shooters at the top of their game battling it out.
By going first, he can put a lot of the pressure on the guys behind him. That's a good score.
So many times we see the best scores in the three-point contest come in round one. I think the players start to get tired legs as they approach the 50-shot mark in the competition.
Yes, the legs, and it's also the adrenaline of the opening stages. Clark, you know, that's worn off, so mentally, by the second round, you can be running a few.
7 straight, he's stringing them together. Home ball, no good. Up to 15 now, and now with 16. Now with 17, feeling it. One last rack remains.
Nice finish. Well done.
Now 20. 21. That's 4 in a row now. He posts a big number. 24 points. What an unbelievable round. Right away you could tell it was going to be special.
He sure did. I mean, he really showed his potential shooting the ball when he dropped those 8 consecutive shots.
Well, this will be tough. Even to Tom, he's got to have 23 points.
Yeah, he can miss 2 more shots in this round, but that's it.
3 down.
He can only miss 1 more, guys. A second miss, and he's done.
Gets the money ball. 7 points. Oh, and with that miss, he's out.
Unlucky here in the final round. He just couldn't get any momentum moving forward.
He had the highest score in the last round. Let's see if he can do it again here in the final.
After absolutely lighting it up in the qualifying round, let's see what kind of encore he can give us in the final.
Well, if it's anything close to his output in that round, it could be one of the all-time great three-point contest performances overall.
Three more misses, and he's out. Now, 3 points.
Only one miss to spare the rest of the way.
Well, I think that's it. He's done.
Yep, he can't make it up in these last few shots, Kevin.
Well, thanks for coming, and we'll see you next year.
This year's champion was simply astounding behind the arc.
Now, how much fun was that? That could be the highlight of this year's All-Star festivities, guys.
Well, for me, Clark, the three-point contest usually is. I was just happy to have a ringside seat for it.
And the drama, the excitement, this year's three-point contest had it all. And it was our pleasure to bring it to you. For myself, Kevin Harlan, and my partners, Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, thank you, everyone, and good night.